Hello everybody, it's Shermel. We're trucking with Shermel. On today's video, we're going to talk once again about moving over when something's on the shoulder. A young lady tragically lost her life getting hit by a semi in the rear end. She was on the shoulder. We got a shower today, so I'm going to show you what the inside of a shower looks like at this particular truck stop chain. But before we get too deep in that thing, because it's going to get deep, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and tell a friend to tell a friend to what? Write it down in the comments. To tell another friend to come join the family. Let's go.
You'll see him in a minute because he's coming around me now. This is how selfish people are. This is how impatient people are, and I'm passionate about it. Get over. You can't be in that much of a rush. And he passed me on the right when I got over for that car back there. You can't be that much in a hurry that you're willing to risk yourself and somebody else. You can hit them and something happened to you. It's crazy, man. It's sad. It really is. It's sad that that's where we are. Everybody's in a rush to get nowhere. And I think part of it is people are in a rush, and I think part of it is people just don't know. But there's signs posted. But, you know, reading it, you know, everybody can't read, and I get that. And I understand that part of reading is getting your license. But now they have it where you can listen to it, and that takes away being able to read the road signs. It does. It makes it unsafe out here. And so, I always get over, man. And there's times cars don't want to let me over. I'll hug the line if I have to, you know, because I'm seeing what you can't see. And I get it. Nobody wants to be stuck behind a truck. I understand that. But if I'm trying to get over, I'm getting over for a reason. Look at this car. He got over right on top of me. A cop comes along and sees that. He's like, oh, you're tailgating. No, I'm not. They got over on top of me. I'm not even doing the speed limit. I'm doing 2 or 3 below the speed limit. So this is unfortunate for that young lady, you know. And I send prayers out to her and her family. And that's another thing. Spiritual fitness, man. You don't know when you're going home to meet the Lord. You don't know when your day coming. So you better be ready. Say everything you need to say to your family, your loved ones. That's why I say in these videos, call your loved ones and tell them you love them. You don't know when that day is coming. She didn't wake up that morning knowing at the end of the day she was going to get hit by a truck. You got to be, you know, look ahead and feet up on the dashboard and all that type of stuff. How you going to be able to react, man, when you driving like you in the recliner at the house? It's, you know, I mean, there isn't such thing as a panic stop. Like, things happen where you need to come to a stop. Man, your foot up on the dash, you chilling, watching a movie, and man, you can't possibly be prepared for what's going to happen out here by that. Because you don't know what's going to happen. We have to, as an industry, you know, and like I said, it's not just trucks, it's the general motoring public, but that's just what's on my heart. I seen that and I'm like, man, you know, she was still in high school, her senior year, and that's got to be a rough way to go, man. I mean, to get hit, get ejected, and then still get ran over by another vehicle, that's bad. So I'm begging and I'm pleading. As much as I plead and beg about slowing down in the bad weather, get over when you can. Try your best, do your best. I know people don't always want to let you over, and that's an issue in itself too. But if you can, get over, please. You don't want that to be your family or their family no more than anybody else's family. So, but we're gonna head over to the truck stop, find us a spot to take a shower. The showers are normally busy in the evenings. Everybody's coming in off the road. And the mornings, before everybody's getting back on the road. Those are going to be your busiest times to where you may have to wait to take a shower. Well, Prime made him a spot in the driveway, man. You know, you don't care. Got sleep, I guess. So that's going to be your busiest times to shower, where you may have to wait. But truck stop's kind of empty, so we should be fine. But if we have to wait, it's no big deal. We got some time, so we'll go in here and take a shower, show you guys what the showers look like and whatnot. And look like it's going to be a beautiful day today. That's the way it's looking, at least. Sunshine, I think it's supposed to be in the upper 50s today. I'm over in Ohio. So, upper 50s today, that'll be nice. You don't gotta fly through these truck stops, man. There's people walking and whatnot, and they don't wanna run nobody over, man. I know I don't. So, actually we're gonna spin around. There's a couple spots to pull through, so we ain't even gotta back up today. Baby don't turn, man. You hear it? Ah. Everybody want a hood. Everybody, I keep saying it. Everybody want a hooded truck, man. That should have been a regular turn right there, and it wasn't. So, I'm going to get my bag together, and I'll see everybody inside. See you in a second.
Alright. Yes, sir.
Need a shower, please?
Shower.
Customer 36.
There
you go. Your shower is ready. Please proceed to shower 1.
13.
Customer 37. Your shower is ready. Please proceed to shower 6. Attention, Love's team members. It is now time for a courtesy check.
Yes,
welcome to Lodge. The time is now 8:30 and it's time for a courtesy check. Can I please get Brennan to the men's room and Maya to the women's? Thank you and have a wonderful morning.
So this is the shower. Actually, you have to do it. This is the shower. They give you a towel, you use your own sword, towel. I use my own towel, but not bad. So, I don't feel here. If I feel here, 50 gallons gets you a shower for 7 days, 5 to 7 days. Excuse me. Since I don't feel here, I'll show you the receipt. I have to pay. I'm at the Love's. $13 for a shower. It's worth it for me, because I don't want to be dirty. And you got your sink, you got a fan, it's kind of humid in here. That's just pretty much it. One thing. Like I said, I use my own towels, my own soap. I don't worry about that. They got soap back here. One is soap and one's like shampoo. You know, you start to shower. They got an upper. When it's wet, you close it at least. They got an upper and a lower. You know, a place to hold your soap or whatever. One thing. Don't never get in the shower without some flip-flops, shower shoes, whatever you want to call them. It don't matter. You gotta have you some shower shoes. You don't want to take no fungus back with you. Don't trust these drivers. You don't know how good these employees are cleaning the showers. Pandemic going on, you want to be as safe as you can be. So this is pretty much it. Not much to it. So you got your own personal shower room, personal toilet, whatever. So that's it. Sink, brush your teeth, mirror, soap by the mirror, fan, door, privacy latch is locked. Latch that door is locked, they can't get in. If you leave the shower, you need to let it, like say you and your wife, you're showering, you know, you need to let one of you leave. Oh, I forgot something. I gotta go get it. You need to go, when you go out, tell the attendant, hey, shower 1, I just had to grab something, going back, because after 10 minutes, it'll be to them that no one's in here. They don't know that though. They just know somebody's left the room. They'll try to come in and clean it. But as long as you have this and the door locked, they won't be able to get in. But let them know, hey, I'm in here. You know, back when I started driving, it wasn't digital like that. The pad to get in, it was a key. You had to get a key. So that's today's video. As I said, ride to your pickup and your delivery on time, safely in one piece. Call your loved ones, tell them you love them. But most importantly, love on somebody today and be the reason somebody smiles today. The world needs it now more than ever. It's Trucking with Shamel, and I'm out. Peace.